My name is Gina Cody. I came to Canada in 1979 during the revolution in Iran. My brother had organized a meeting with me and a professor at Concordia. He looked at my marks and he said, "Why would you go anywhere else? Why don't you come to Concordia and we give you scholarship?" Since I was a child, my mother, who married young, she always said, "I really want you and your sister to continue your education and be independent." I did my PhD and went as much as I could to carry on the mission that was given to me by my mother. Within a year, I was offered a job at a company. Later on, I became a partner and then became the sole owner. 3 years, I was awarded one of the best managed companies.
Gina came to Concordia as a young woman. She was the first woman in her program to finish a PhD in building engineering. Gina's had a long association with the university even after she graduated. She's served on various advisory committees for the university, and for the last 4 years or so, she's been a member of our board of governors. Gina mentioned to me that she might be interested in making a gift. I didn't really understand initially that it would be the transformative gift that it has become. The donation creates scholarships and bursaries for young people who are going to come here and study who might not have otherwise had the opportunity to do so.
She came by and she visited each of the student societies, kind of shook all of our hands and asked what we were doing. So I told her what we were doing, and she was very impressed. By having a woman as the face of the school, I feel comforted. As a woman in a STEM field, we don't see as much discrimination as perhaps historically we have, but there's a lot of struggle that's internalized within questions like, do I belong here? Am I a real engineer? But having a woman as the face of your school is a reminder every day that yes, you do belong here and you can do great things.
I'm quite honored to be given the chance of signing the Leave of the of Montreal. It's a confirmation of acceptance of a person that has made contribution. I was provided with an opportunity that changed my life. Giving back to the society that made you who you are is not an option, it's an obligation. By me giving all these scholarships to all these students, I'm hoping that most of them will do the same thing I did, and the circle continues of people who succeed and give back. That's how Canada was made. That's how we will have an inclusive society.